We are two organizations here in the south of Spain, and we are working with young people, but also with adults. And one of our approaches we developed here is this Shanarani approach, because we wanted to get young people more aware on the stereotypes which they are presented, and we thought, how can we involve them in projects? And here you see a little bit our entities. Asociación Caminos was founded in 2014. We have activities in the field of education and social work, and mostly developing such approaches like this one, because we want to find new ways to involve people, to work with them, to get them aware of something. In the 7 years we are existing now, we are on 20 European projects and two Key Action 1 and one Key Action 3. And we are also accredited as sending and hosting organization here. And the other organization is a consultancy, which we are working mostly on gender issues and on employment issue, which is very important here in the south of Spain, as we have one of the highest youth unemployment rates in Europe, which is over 50%. So you can imagine youth work is an important issue here. And now we are coming to the point of the name, which you were very interesting. It's a name from the Indian population, which means that it's applicable for male and female. So we used it to symbolize this gender equality. This is why we choose this name. And we developed this approach for a project which we had from 2017 to 2019. And we thought, if we want to involve young people in working on this topic, nobody will be interested if we say, oh, come on, let's talk about gender stereotypes, because they just will say, oh, no, I'm not interested, I don't need this or whatever. And so we thought to work via music and via video and things which young people are very interested, because then they are more happy to join us in these trainings. And by talking about these videos and about these music clips, we can help them to get the ability to analyze and to realize the gender stereotypes which they are presented in all these media. And if in the next step we talk with them about the consequences for their later life, how their personal decisions are influenced by these pictures, what they see, so it will be, it would have more impact for them for their life. And in this project, we developed different handbooks, which are still available in the internet if someone wants to read them. It's handbook with theory impact, but also activities which you can use in youth work. And one of the problems of this project was that the Spanish National Agency cut down the budget more than half. So we really didn't have all the money what we wanted to have to be able to develop something. So this part here, we also did something like a life choice simulator. And this one, we did our best possible, but it's really very simple. Because here we didn't have the money to do something more technically developed, but you can enter it and see it. It's very interesting, because what we did is to present the different steps of decisions in your life. For example, if you're a child, with which toys are you playing? If you are in school, which educational choices do you do? And how these decisions might influence your later life, depending how much you will earn, depending your risk of poverty and all these. But as I said, it's very simple. And as this Here you also see some explanation about this simulator. It's clear that we cannot present everything. It's really a simplified version, but it helps to sensitize to see the impact of decisions which you do during your life at different stages, so that you see what is the effect at the end. And as I said before, the project was very poorly funded, so we are happy to have a follow-up project which was funded last year. And here Vanessa now will take over, because this project, the new one, the Shanarani Youth Led, she is managing, and so she is best aware of all the key facts on this project.
So nice to meet everyone. I'm going to talk about Shanarani YouthNet. So this is, as Angela said, an ongoing project. It started in 2020 and will go to until 2022. So the partners and the lead partner is from the United Kingdom, and other partners are Spain, Italy, Romania, and Greece. A few of the partners are different from the last project, which gives a new level and some new information as well. And Shanarani Youth-Led is about reducing gender stereotypes and the influence of gender roles. And in this case, we do it through film and television. Through this project, we already created a guide with activities, with learning content for professionals in youth work. And therefore, we have two workshops at the moment. One is for professionals and one is for young people themselves, to learn about stereotypes, to be able to identify them, and to be able to get the self-confidence to overcome them. There will also be a game and a mobile application during the project to learn through them how gender stereotypes influence our daily life. And at the end, there will be an official ebook, as well as through the UK partner, we also have an official certification on the European standards. Yes, so as I said, we are currently implementing the workshops, and the one big difference between this one and the last project is that it's really youth-led based, as the name says. So it's very interactive activities. It's not about lecturing, it's not about showing someone what they should know, but it's about helping them understand and explore it themselves. The trainer only gives them an introduction to it, and otherwise there's a video analysis, there is an analysis of advertisements, there are practical activities where they connect it to their daily activities, their daily lives, and their daily decisions. And so this youth-led approach is very important for the project and can be seen in all the activities we have. And as I said, we already have developed the workshop, and we structured it in four topics. So we, in the first workshop, it's about showing them, the first workshop is revolving around common and uncommon portrayals of gender in film and television and the reproduction thereof, how we see it like in movies, how we see it in movies from different countries. So it's not just about one country, or it's not just about Hollywood. The workshop two has two topics, the gender gap and discrimination in film and television productions, and the stereotypes in media and news coverage. This is about what is behind the scenes. So it's about salaries, about careers, about chances female and male people get in the film and television productions, as well as like doing interviews and in advertisements. And the last topic is the promotion of new role models and improved individuality and reducing the influence of stereotypical portrayals among young people. This one revolves more about raising their self-confidence and enabling them to overcome stereotypes, to help others overcome stereotypes, and and to find new role models for their future or be their own role model. Okay, in that case, we are already at the methodology part. So we prepared today two videos. We will separate into groups where each group watches the video, and afterwards we have prepared a few questions which are about the scene we saw, where we can discuss about it, and then where we can analyze it.